Hello students, so till now we have discussed that how the reflection takes place from the plane mirror, right? And what actually happens in the plane mirror, right? Like it just changes the direction of the ray, isn't it? Now we'll talk about certain different kinds of mirror also. So there can be certain different mirrors, and I'll talk about the spherical mirror now. Now see, spherical mirrors are actually little curved kind of mirrors, right? Plane mirrors are the plane mirror where we have studied the characteristics of the plane mirror, how the images are formed, how does the reflection takes place, which kind of image is formed, isn't it? Now the spherical mirrors are little, you know, curved mirrors, right? And we will draw, and you know, it will be very easy to understand. So it is just the beginning, and so it may take little time to understand, children. So spherical mirrors are curved mirrors. They are curved actually, and so they can also be known as curved mirrors, right? Now in the plane mirror, only the reflection takes place and the direction of the ray changes. But here in the spherical mirror, you know what can happen? Even light get converged, and some, is it visible, right? And even diverge. Now these are two new terms which I have used over here. Now what is the meaning of converge and what is the meaning of diverge? Now see children, converge means what? Actually, when the different rays of light, okay, are coming, they come together. So bringing them together, coming the rays, when the rays come together, it is known as what? Converging. So converging can be like bringing, like different kind of, different rays actually, they are coming and they are meeting at one particular time. This is known as convergence, right? So different rays, they are coming from the different directions, right? But they are meeting at one place, that means they are getting converged, right? So spherical mirrors, we are talking about spherical mirrors are little curved, and so they are also known as curved mirrors or spherical mirrors. Now the spherical mirrors, now we'll be discussing about the types. But as I said, like plane mirrors only, what they do, they just change the direction of the parallel beams, right? Now here the spherical mirrors, what can happen with these kind of mirrors? They can converge the rays. That means the different direction, the rays which are coming from the different directions, they come and they meet at one place. Now what is the meaning of diverge? Just opposite of converging. That means rays, they are coming and getting scattered in different directions, right? So this is the, like the rays are coming and it is like ray comes and get scattered in different directions. So this will be known as what? Like we will say, like the rays are getting diverged. So divergence and convergence are the two new terms over here. Now So now we will be talking about the types of spherical mirrors, right? So actually spherical mirrors can be of two types, concave, or it can be also pronounced as concave, whatever you feel comfortable with. So concave and convex, right? Convex mirror and concave mirror. We are studying here now about the concave and convex mirrors. Now these mirrors are, you know, they are known as spherical mirrors. They are the, like the, when we talk about the types of the spherical mirrors, so we include concave and convex mirror in this. So now first of all, what is the meaning of spherical mirror? So if I want to write a definition, so it will come up in this way: a spherical mirror is that mirror. So it can be defined as, a spherical mirror is that mirror which or whose So if you have to define spherical mirror, how can we define? A spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is part of a hollow sphere. Right? So a spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is part of a hollow sphere. Now this is just a definition. How to understand this? What is the meaning of this? So now we'll talk more about these two mirrors. Now see, when I talk about concave mirror, right? So how a concave mirror will be. So see children, this is a concave, see this I have drawn just a, you know, part of a sphere, isn't it? So a spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is part of a hollow sphere. First thing to understand, like this mirror is the part of a hollow sphere, right? This mirror is a part of a hollow sphere. Now I have just drawn this curved surface. Till now it doesn't falls under any category, neither concave nor convex. Now what is the meaning of the concave mirror? Children, reflection, this is the mirror, right? Now in mirror, one side is always, you know, coated with some silver lining. Silver lining is there, silver coating is there. So in concave mirror, what will happen, children? This surface here, where I'm drawing certain small oblique lines, isn't it? So this is a part which is covered by the silver coating. So what is there, children? Here, silver coating is there. And this part is the reflecting surface. That means in the concave mirror, the reflection takes place, you know, takes place through the concave surface. In a concave mirror, the reflection takes place by the concave surface. Now, what is the meaning of concave? You can see this. I have drawn like this, isn't it? Now, this part is covered by some silver coating. And this is the bent part. Isn't it? This is a bent part. This is the concave part. Now the reflection takes place from this part. And so such kind of mirrors will be known as concave mirror. And definitely this is a part of the hollow sphere. How it is a part of the hollow sphere, children? If I draw it completely, so here it comes as the sphere. And what we are saying in the definition also, spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface, now this here, this is a reflecting surface, I can even name it as A. This surface can be named as, you know, named as A. Which one? The reflecting surface. So I'll label it like this, reflecting surface. Right, this A part is reflecting surface and B part is silver coated. It is coated by silver, right? So reflection cannot take place by the silver coated surface. Definitely it will take by the opposite part. So reflection takes place by the from the concave part, from the bent part, from the inward part. And so this kind of mirrors are known as concave mirror, right? So now this is the concave side. Here I will again, now here we will be talking about the convex mirror. So now again, a part of a hollow sphere, how does it is, it can be known as part of the hollow sphere. So if I make it like this, children, again it will, it is understood like it is a part of the hollow sphere. It is not drawn properly, but still right. So it is the part of the it is the part of the hollow sphere. Now here now the place where the silver coating was there, that was coated, you know, like here the oblique lines were drawn, isn't it? Here this part, the oblique lines are drawn because this is coated by silver, and the, from here the reflection do not takes place. Now first of all, now where this the reflection will takes place from this mirror. Now this will be this side, the bent part, the concave part will be coated by silver, isn't it? And it will be like silver coating will be there. Now the reflection will not take place from the concave part, from the inward part, from the bent part. Where the reflection will take place? From this bulging part, isn't it? See, you can see like here I have coated, okay, or I can say I have drawn these oblique lines on the bulgy part. But here I am telling that the reflection takes place from this bulgy part, isn't it? And this inward part is coated with the silver, you know, thing, and from here no reflection will takes place, right? So if I want to again write A and B, so as this one is A and this part is B, but here the B is reflecting surface. And this is the silver coating. Right? Now, so what we are doing, what we are studying, we are talking about the spherical mirror, children. Spherical mirrors are curved. So you can see these are curved mirrors, isn't it? These are curved mirrors, and so they can also be known as curved mirrors. Now, these spherical mirrors can be of two types, concave and convex type. Now, what is the biggest difference like when we see? So what will be the difference? Here the reflection takes place from the here. Reflection takes place from the concave or the bent part, right? Whereas here reflection takes